Later that night, the spirit inside Akwanwa resurfaced. As her mother went to the bathroom, Akwanwa used her powers to make Mrs. Ferdinand fall and break her leg. It was a painful experience, and Mrs. Ferdinand had to be rushed to the hospital. Once upon a time, in a small village, there lived a sweet little girl named Akwanwa. She was 10 years old and the only child of Mr. and Mrs. Ferdinand. Akwanwa was very pretty, and her parents, especially her mother, Mrs. Ferdinand, adored her a lot. It took them many years to have Akwanwa, so Mrs. Ferdinand tended to pamper her excessively. Now, Mr. Ferdinand, Akwanwa's father, often warned his wife not to spoil their daughter too much, but Mrs. Ferdinand paid little attention to his advice. Mr. Ferdinand worked in a town far away from their village, so he was away from home most of the time. Akwanwa, on the other hand, took advantage of her mother's protective nature. She became a troublemaker in the village, disrespecting elders and picking fights with her playmates. What made matters worse was that Mrs. Ferdinand wouldn't allow anyone to correct or discipline Akwanwa. She even went as far as fighting and threatening to arrest anyone who dared to correct her daughter. One day, a woman named Omasiri, who lived next door to Akwanwa's family, was cooking outside her door. Akwanwa, being mischievous, watched as Omasiri went inside to grab some ingredients. Seizing the opportunity, Akwanwa hurriedly poured sand into Omasiri's pot of soup. When Omasiri came out and discovered what had happened, she was understandably upset. She questioned Akwanwa about it, and to everyone's surprise, Akwanwa proudly admitted to the misdeed. She even boldly declared that Omasiri couldn't do anything about it because her mother would come to her rescue. Omasiri, feeling furious and betrayed, grabbed a cane and decided it was time to teach Akwanwa a lesson. She gave the little troublemaker a good scolding and a thorough beating. Akwanwa cried, but this time, there was no one to protect her. Later that day, Mrs. Ferdinand returned home and found Akwanwa in tears, shocked and angered by the marks on her daughter's body. She demanded an explanation. Akwanwa pointed towards Omasiri's door, and without hesitation, Mrs. Ferdinand stormed towards Omasiri's apartment. Upon reaching there, Mrs. Ferdinand unleashed a torrent of insult on Omasiri. She called her a witch and made hurtful remarks about her marital status and age. Mrs. Ferdinand even went as far as saying Omasiri would never get married or have children. Omasiri, devastated by the harsh words, could only cry and couldn't find the strength to respond. After venting her anger, Mrs. Ferdinand left, leaving Omasiri shattered and vowing to make her pay for the humiliation. Determined to turn the tables, Omasiri decided to leave the village and embark on an unknown journey, leaving the villagers wondering about the mysterious event that would unfold. After Omasiri left the village, things didn't get any better with Mrs. Ferdinand and Akwanwa. They continued causing trouble, picking fights, and even arresting people in the village. Mr. Ferdinand, who walked far away, had no idea about the chaos his family was creating. One day, when Mr. Ferdinand returned from work, he was greeted by a crowd of villagers complaining about the misbehavior of his wife and daughter. Saddened by the news, he went home angrily. determined to address the issue. Mr. Ferdinand called for a family meeting, hoping to sort out the problems. Akwanwa, true to her troublesome nature, got aggressive and insulted her father. Mr. Ferdinand, not tolerating her disrespect, became angry and decided it was time to take action. He took a cane and gave Akwanwa a stern punishment, flogging her mercilessly. Mrs. Ferdinand could only beg as Akwanwa cried for help. After the punishment, Mr. Ferdinand locked Akwanwa in her room, insisting that she needed to learn her lessons. That night, after having a long discussion with his wife about Akwanwa, Mr. Ferdinand had his dinner and went to sleep. As soon as Mrs. Ferdinand realized her husband had fallen asleep, she sneaked out of their room and unlocked Akwanwa's door. She comforted her daughter and left her to rest in her room. However, something mysterious was about to happen. Akwanwa, feeling a strange fire in her eyes, left her room and entered her parents' bedroom. Enchanting unknown words, she stood over her sleeping father. Suddenly, Mr. Ferdinand started struggling for breath and eventually stopped breathing altogether. The mysterious spirit left Akwanwa, who screamed for help. Mrs. Ferdinand rushed into the room. Finding her husband lifeless, she screamed, begged him to come back, and asked Akwanwa what happened. Akwanwa, unable to explain the strange occurrence, said she found her father like that. Neighbors, including Omasiri, who had returned the previous night, gathered to console Mrs. Ferdinand. The village was filled with sadness and confusion as they tried to make sense of the tragic event. Days passed, and the sadness lingered in Mrs. Ferdinand's heart after her husband's funeral. Overwhelmed with regret, she realized the need to change Akwanwa's behavior. Mrs. Ferdinand called her daughter and sat her down for a serious talk. Regretful, Mrs. Ferdinand urged Akwanwa to become a better person. However, Akwanwa's response was unexpected. She got very angry and disrespectful, telling her mother to shut up. Mrs. Ferdinand, shocked by the level of disrespect, attempted to slap Akwanwa, but something strange happened. Akwanwa's eyes started glowing with light, and she began enchanting unknown words. The only thing Mrs. Ferdinand heard was, "I am your pain, and you will suffer until your last breath." Terrified, Mrs. Ferdinand tried to run out of the house. When Akwanwa returned to normal, she was surprised to see her mother running away. Confused, she called her back, asking what happened. It was then that Mrs. Ferdinand realized that her daughter had been possessed, and she knew she needed to find a solution before it was too late. Trying to keep the situation calm, Mrs. Ferdinand assured Akwanwa that everything was fine. They both went back inside, but Mrs. Ferdinand couldn't shake off the fear that had gripped her. Later that night, the spirit inside Akwanwa resurfaced. As her mother went to the bathroom, Akwanwa used her powers to make Mrs. Ferdinand fall and break her leg. It was a painful experience, and Mrs. Ferdinand had to be rushed to the hospital. The doctors delivered the heartbreaking news that she couldn't walk anymore. Mrs. Ferdinand now relied on wheelchair for support. The spirit continued tormenting their family through Akwanwa. Faced with the worsening situation, Mrs. Ferdinand decided it was time to reveal everything to Akwanwa. She told her about the possession, the enchanting words, and the consequences they brought. Akwanwa, defensive and in denial, claimed it wasn't true. However, the spirits had taken permanent residence within Akwanwa and refused to leave. From that point on, Akwanwa's behavior became even more cruel. She maltreated her mother, pushed her away, and neglected her needs. Akwanwa wouldn't give her food or water, and she refused to assist her to the bathroom. Mrs. Ferdinand, now helpless, had to endure the pain and humiliation caused by her own daughter. Akwanwa locked her mother up in a room and didn't bother checking up on her. with a heart full of hatred. Akwango swore to make her mother suffer until the very end. Akwango, now controlled by a mysterious force, turned into an agent sent to destroy her own mother. She put on a fake smile and became a very good child to their neighbors, especially to Omasiri. Akwango helped Omasiri's chores, swept her house, washed her dishes, and even fetched water for her. Surprisingly, she ate at Omasiri's house while leaving her own mother hungry. The neighbors, unaware of the true situation, thought Akwango was just being a helpful child. One day, Agnes, a neighbor, became suspicious and confronted Omasiri. She asked if Akwango was ever helpful to her own mother since she seemed to spend all her time at Omasiri's house. Omasiri, defensive and secretive, told Agnes to stay away from her business and leave Akwango alone. Agnes persisted, confronting Akwango to caution her to take care of her sick mother. However, instead of a reasonable response, Agnes was met with a cold and scary face, making her flee in fear. Akwango continued to torment anyone who tried to help her mother. She scared them away and became Omasiri's errand girl. The neighbors started suspecting that Omasiri was behind Akwango's family predicament, but they had no proof. One day, Mrs. Ferdinand screamed for help, and Agnes, hearing her cries, ran to her aid. Akwango had left the compound with Omasiri. Agnes, upon entering Mrs. Ferdinand's room, was hit by a terrible smell. Despite this, she managed to open the door and windows, then hurriedly called some men to assist in bringing Mrs. Ferdinand out of the house. As they carried Mrs. Ferdinand to Agnes's house, she provided her with food, water, and helped her wash and change her clothes. Mrs. Ferdinand shared the sad stories of her family with Agnes, begging for help. Agnes, touched by the plight of her neighbor, assured her that she would help. That night, Omasiri and Akwango returned and noticed Mrs. Ferdinand was not in her room. Omasiri, using her supposed spiritual eyes, directed Akwango to Agnes's apartment. As Akwango's eyes glowed, she angrily inflicted an evil spell on Agnes, causing her to fall and tragically die. Mrs. Ferdinand, witnessing the horrifying event, cried and begged Akwango to spare her. Ignoring her pleas, Akwango, now possessed by the spirit, invoked spiritual powers and gave Mrs. Ferdinand the beating of her life. After the brutal punishment, she carried her mother back to her room and locked her up again. The battle between good and evil continued, leaving the village in fear and confusion. The neighbors remained suspicious of Omasiri, but the true nature of the mysterious force controlling Akwango remained hidden. The fate of Mrs. Ferdinand and her daughter hung in the balance, with darkness casting a shadow over their once peaceful home. The next morning, the neighbors were shocked to discover Agnes's mysterious death. But fear held them back from confronting Akwango due to her spiritual powers. Akwango left her mother locked up and moved into Omasiri's house, where they laughed and ate together. Strangely, Akwango started calling Omasiri mother and referred to Mrs. Ferdinand as a witch. Time passed, and a powerful man of God named Pastor John was transferred to the village. He possessed the power of God and saw a vision about the Ferdinand family being caged by a woman. The villagers informed him about the family, and he headed to their house. Upon entering the compound, the atmosphere changed, but Pastor John remained unshaken. Akwango approached and asked who sent him. Pastor John replied that God sent him to deliver her. Akwango laughed, warning him to leave or face their consequences. Pastor John smiled and declared, "He that is in me is greater than he that is in the world." Akwanwa attempted to use her powers against Pastor John, but his Bible subdued her. Exhausted, she summoned Omasiri, who invoked her powers. A spiritual battle unfolded until Pastor John conquered and defeated Omasiri. She lay on the floor gasping for breath. Meanwhile, in the room where Mrs. Ferdinand was locked up, a light appeared and she stood up with renewed energy. As she ran outside, she found her daughter on the floor and embraced her. Pastor John instructed Omasiri to confess, revealing the evil deeds she had done. Omasiri confessed to everything, from causing Akwanwa to kill her father to making Mrs. Ferdinand trip and fall and break her leg. She admitted to manipulating Akwanwa to see her mother as a witch and worship her. Omasiri took responsibility for Agnes's death, expressing no remorse but regretting leaving Mrs. Ferdinand alive. She disclosed traveling to the great beyond to gain her powers. The neighbors, shocked by the confession, learned that Omasiri had traveled far to inflict pain on Mrs. Ferdinand. Akwanwa regained consciousness, hugged her mother, and questioned what had happened. Omasiri, trying to approach Akwanwa, faced resistance as people held her back. Pastor John declared that Akwanwa had been delivered and the spells were lifted. Omasiri, furious, attempted to grab Akwanwa by force, but the neighbors restrained her. Pastor John spoke about repentance and forgiveness, prayed for them, and urged them to seek God's face. Mrs. Ferdinand apologized to the neighbors for her behavior, pledging to do better. Akwanwa also apologized, and in the spirit of reconciliation, Omasiri angrily left the compound. Days later, it was discovered that she died in the bush. Finally, Mrs. Ferdinand and Akwanwa came together, forging a new path in their lives. They shared stories, cautioning parents to train their children well and mindful of their words. The village learned valuable lessons about forgiveness, repentance, and the power of redemption, as they embraced a future free from the grip of darkness. Parents, it's important to teach your children good values, because the way you guide them when they are young stays with them as they grow. Be careful with the words you say to others. Mean words can lead to revenge and sadness. Let's always choose kind words to make the world a better place. No matter what happens, forgiveness is powerful. Holding on to anger can be like letting the devil use us to hurt others. Instead, forgive and choose love. In this story, Akwanwa and her mother faced many challenges because of hurtful words and actions. But in the end, when they choose forgiveness, their lives became better. So let's be kind, watch our words, and forgive each other to make the world a happier and safer place. Thanks for watching this story about Akwanwa on African Stories. If you liked it and felt inspired with your journey, please show your support by clicking the like button, sharing with your friends, and leaving a comment below. To see more interesting stories and learn about different cultures, subscribe to African Stories. And don't forget to ring the notification bell so you never miss a new story. Your support means a lot and helps us bring more stories to you. Until we meet again, stay connected, stay inspired, and keep smiling.